Welcome to the tutorial PowerXL DM1 Variable Frequency Drive, establishing a Modbus TCP connection with software PowerXpert in control. To establish a Modbus TCP connection from the software PowerXpert in control to the DM1 Pro frequency inverter, the following technical requirements need to be met. A PowerXL frequency inverter DM1 Pro, a patch cable, for example DXCBL RG45 3M0, the software PowerXpert in control, which can be downloaded free of charge from the Eaton homepage, optionally a USB to RG45 adapter if no or no free RG45 interface is available for the connection via Modbus TCP. After opening the front cover, you will find the RG45 port for the Modbus TCP connection on the left side. At the PC, either a free RG45 interface is to be used or an RG45 interface is to be provided via USB adapter. In this example, the address range 192.168.0.0.1 with the possible end addresses 1 to 254 is used. At the DM1 Pro, the default fixed IP address 192.168.0.0.1.254 is used. At the PC, the address 192.168.0.0.1.0.10 is used as an example. To set the desired fixed IP address on the PC, open the network connection via the Windows key plus X. In the following window, the Network and Sharing Center is selected. The Network Ethernet 3 via USB adapter is selected here as a variant. Via Properties, the Internet Protocol version 4 is selected. With the default, use the following IP address, enter the desired IP address, here 192.168.0.0.1.0.10 together with the subnet mask. Then confirm the entries with OK. For reasons of cybersecurity, the communication via Modbus TCP is deactivated at the DM1 Pro in the default settings. For the unlocking of the communication, the parameter P12.3.1 Modbus TCP enable has to be changed from 0 to 1 enable. The software PowerXpert in control is started with a double click and an empty project is opened. To the network on the left side, the Modbus TCP connection can be added in three different ways: via the green plus sign, by drag and drop, or by double click. In the next step, the PowerXL DM1 frequency inverter can be connected to the Modbus TCP connection in the same way, in this case by drag and drop. The next window, the default setting is kept and accepted with Set. Automatically, the window for the drive selection appears. In this case, the DM1 Pro is selected with the DM1-321D6 to be connected. The mains voltage of 230V and the firmware version 1.07 used here. Standard is selected from the four different applications available for selection. After confirmation of the selection, the startup wizard is started by Yes. After entering the desired data, in this example the default setting is used, the wizard is completed by pressing the Finish button. If desired, the name of the drive can be changed on the left side. This is recommended for larger networks with several drives in order to clearly identify them later in the project. In the context menu of the drive, called by the right mouse button, the establishment of the communication between PC and drive is started. The current parameters from the DM1 Pro drive are uploaded to the software. If the DM1 Pro is in stop status, changes of parameter can now be carried out according to the application requirement. Change parameters are stored directly in the drive and do not require any additional action from the software Power Expert in Control. Thank you for your attention.